Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة محمد بن سيدنا محمد. إن الحمد لله تفرد بالربوبية وأبان للإنسانية دلائل الألوهية. أحمده تعالى وأشكره على ما أسدى من منة وعطية ودفع من نقمة وبلية. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أنقذنا بالبعثة المحمدية من براثن الإشراك والوثنية، وأعزنا بالتوحيد وأبطل مسالك الجاهلية. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، خير البرية وسيد البشرية، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين أشادوا صروح الحنيفية وأعلوا منار الملة المصطفوية، والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. My dear brothers and sisters, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to gather on this blessed day, the day of Jumu'ah. And this particular Jumu'ah is the best Jumu'ah of the year because it comes in the best 10 days of the year. The first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah are greater than any other days of the year. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهِنَّ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ. That there are no days where good deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these days, these first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. They are the greatest days of the year. So when Jumu'ah comes in one of these 10 days, then that Jumu'ah is the greatest Jumu'ah of the year. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to gather on this blessed day. And from the great days that are yet to come is the day of Arafah, which will fall on Monday, inshallah, this Monday. The day of Arafah is one of the greatest days of the year. And even amongst the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, it has a great and special significance. There are many blessings of the day of Arafah. And inshallah, in this khutbah, we will cover some of those virtues of the day of Arafah. And we will talk about some of the things that we can do to maximize the benefit that we get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. The day of Arafah is the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed this religion for us. It is the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected Islam for us. During the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, when he was the Khalifa, a Jewish man came to him and he said to him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, إنكم تقرؤون آية في كتابكم لو نزلت علينا معشر اليهود لاتخذنا ذلك اليوم عيدا. He said, O leader of the believers, there is a verse that you read in your book that if this verse was revealed to us Jews, we would have taken that day as a day of festival and a day of celebration. And then Umar radiallahu anhu asked this Jewish man, what is the ayah that you are referring to? And the Jewish man replied by mentioning the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on this day I have perfected your religion for you and I have completed my favor onto you and I am pleased to give you Islam as your religion. So when Umar radiallahu anhu heard this, he said, Wallahi inni la'a'lamu fi ayyi yawmin unzilat wa fi ayyi sa'ah wa ayna unzilat wa ayna kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hina unzilat. Unzilat wa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fina yakhtub wa nahnu wukufun bi'arafah. Umar radiallahu anhu said, I swear by Allah that I know the day that this verse was revealed, and I know the time that this verse was revealed, and I know where this verse was revealed, the location, and I know where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was at the time that this verse was revealed. This verse was revealed while the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was addressing us, was giving us a khutbah while we were standing in the plain of Arafah. So the day of Arafah, the place of Arafah, it is something of great significance in Islam, the day that our religion was completed. Also, from the greatness of the day of Arafah, the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by this day in the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. الشَّفْعِ is the even and الْوَتْرِ is the odd. So الشَّفْعِ here, the even, it is referring to the day of Eid, Al-Adha, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, because that is an even numbered day, the 10th. And وَالْوَتْرِ, the odd, that is referring to the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, which is an odd numbered day. And that is the day of Arafah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by it. Also in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود. Abu Huraira and Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, they said, الشاهد يوم الجمعة والمشهود يوم عرفة. That الشاهد, the witness, it is the day of Jumu'ah, and the one that is witnessed, المشهود, it is the day of عرفة. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by the day of عرفة in the Quran. So we can see here that it is a time and it is a day of great significance. Also from the virtues and the blessings on the day of Arafah is that it is the day where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees the most people from the fire of Jahannam. It is the day, unlike any other day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees people from the fire of Jahannam. on other days as well, but there is no day where he frees more people than the day of Arafah. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma min yawmin akthara min an yu'tiqa Allahu fihi 'abdan min an-nar min yawmi Arafah." That there is no day where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees more people from the fire than the day of Arafah. So it is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given great significance to. It is a day that has a great status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should give it the respect that it deserves as well. Also on the day of Arafah, from the virtues of that day, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sees the people who have gathered in Arafah with their ihram, with their hair disheveled, and their bodies dusty, in a state of complete humbleness and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boasts about these servants of His to the angels. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna Allaha yubahi bi ahli arafatin malaikat as-sama' fayaqul unzuru ila ibadi ha'ula ja'uni shu'than ghubra." That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He boasts about the people at Arafah to the angels in the heaven. And He says to them, "Look at these servants of mine. They have come to me with disheveled hair, and they have come to me with dust on their clothes and their body. They have come in a state of complete submission and humbleness, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their needs, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boasts about these people to His angels. Again, this shows the greatness and the significance of the day of Arafah. In another narration, it is mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about these people at Arafah, "Ja'u min kulli fajjin amiq yarjuna rahmati wa lam yaraw azabi." That they have come from every mountainous path. They have come from all over the place. And they hope for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have come for the reason that they hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon them. Even though they have not seen the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they still have hope for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have hope that they will be saved from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boasts about them to the inhabitants of the skies. Also from the virtues of the day of Arafah is that fasting on that day is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards the believers with a great reward. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Siyamu yawmi Arafah ahtasibu ala Allahi an yukaffir as-sanata allati qablahu was-sanata allati ba'dahu." Fasting on the day of Arafah, I have hope with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this fasting will serve as an expiation for the sins of the previous year and the sins of the year that comes after it. So 2 years worth of sins wiped out when you fast for one day, and that day is the day of Arafah. So even if a person is not able to fast on other days during these blessed 10 days, then at least you should not allow the day of Arafah to pass you by without fasting on that day. There are many people, alhamdulillah, who are fasting all of the first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. This is something that is good. But if you cannot fast on all of those days, at least make sure that you fast on the 9th of Dhul Hijjah. Fast this Monday, the day of Arafah, in order to get this great reward that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned. Expiation of 2 years worth of sins. Also from the virtues of the day of Arafah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, it is a day where the shaitan is humiliated. It is a day where the shaitan feels dejected and angry and ashamed and embarrassed. He is made very small on that day. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma ru'iya ash-shaytanu yawman huwa fihi asghar wala adhar wala ahqar wala aghyad minhu fi yawmi Arafah wa ma dhaka illa lima ra'a min tanazzul ar-rahmah wa tajawuz Allahi 'an adh-dhunubi al-'idham illa ma uriya yawma badr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the shaitan has not been seen smaller or more rejected or more disgraced or more angry than he is seen on the day of Arafah. That's the worst day of the year for him. Because on that day he sees the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming down to the people. He sees that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving people for great sins. So when the shaitan sees this, it is something that makes him upset and it makes him dejected and humiliated. So he is the most humiliated on that day. And the only exception where he was more humiliated than that is the humiliation that he received on the day of the Battle of Badr. That was the most humiliated the shaitan has ever been. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, wama ra'a yawma badr? What did the shaitan see on the day of Badr that made him so humiliated and made him feel so small? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ama innahu qad ra'a Jibreel yaza'ul malaika. He said, on that day he saw Jibreel arranging the angels for battle, arranging the lines of the angels to participate in the Battle of Badr. The shaitan saw that. And when he saw that, he felt more humiliated and more rejected and more scared than he had ever felt before. So this is the greatness of this day, the day of Arafah. A day where the shaitan is humiliated. A day where the believers receive special mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They receive pardon from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boasts about the people who are making hajj at Arafah to the angels in the sky. A day of great significance. And that is why it's very important to make sure that you spend that day as much as possible in dua. Making dua, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your needs. Because that is the best opportunity, it's the best time, the best day to make dua. The best dua that you can make is the dua on the day of Arafah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خَيْرُ الدُّعَاء دُعَاءُ يَوْمِ عَرَفَةً. That the best dua is the dua on the day of Arafah. So spend that day as much as possible making dua, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your needs in this world and for His reward in the hereafter and for safety from the punishment in this world and in the hereafter. Beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you can on that day. Humble yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Him for whatever you need. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خَيْرُ الدُّعَاء دُعَاءُ يَوْمِ عَرَفَةً وَخَيْرُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. The best dua is the dua on the day of Arafah. And the best thing that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the prophets that came before him, the best form of dua that they made on that day is La ilaha illallahu wahdahu la sharika lah lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Right, this is praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, testifying to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So say this, make this dua as much as possible and other du'as as well. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for anything that you need. Don't let that opportunity pass you by, and it is very, very likely that your dua will be accepted. It is very likely that the dua that you make on the day of Arafah will be accepted by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't let that opportunity pass you by. So the day of Arafah, it is a day that is special and significant in and of itself. And if you're fasting on that day and making dua on that day, then the blessings that you will receive on that day are even more, inshallah. So make sure that you take advantage of this chance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. The day of Arafah, it only comes once a year, one day in the year. So don't let that day pass you by without you taking full advantage of the opportunities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in that day. Also, from the important acts of the sunnah that starts on the day of Arafah is at-takbir al-muqayyad. The takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahil hamd. The general unrestricted takbir, this should start from the beginning of the month of Dhul Hijjah. From when you see the crescent of Dhul Hijjah, you start the takbir and you do it as much as you can throughout these 10 days and even after the 10 days for the 3 days of Ayyamut Tashriq. So from the beginning of the month up to the 13th of Dhul Hijjah, we should be doing this as much as possible. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahil Hamd. But on the day of Arafah, starting from Fajr on the day of Arafah, there is an additional takbir to be said at the end of the Fard prayer. So after you perform Salatul Fajr on the day of Arafah, you say the takbir after you finish the prayer. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahil Hamd. It starts from Fajr on the day of Arafah and you do it after each one of the obligatory five prayers. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, on the day of Arafah, also on the day of Eid after the five prayers, and also on the days of Tashriq, on the 11th and the 12th, and it ends at Asr. The last one that you do is after Salatul Asr on the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. This is known as At-Takbir Al-Muqayyad, the restricted takbir that is attached to the Salah. It starts on the day of Arafah after Salatul Fajr. So this is a sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that perhaps many people don't know about, and because they don't know about it, they don't practice it. So let us try to revive this sunnah, inshallah, during these blessed days. So these are some of the virtues of the day of Arafah and some of the things that we can do on the day of Arafah, inshallah, in order to maximize the potential reward that we can get. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to witness the day of Arafah coming this Monday, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to witness it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to spend that day in a way that is pleasing to Him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq to do great acts of ibadah on that day, to fast on that day, to make dua on that day, to do other acts of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us away from sin and disobedience at all times, but especially on these blessed days. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our shortcomings. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala maximize our rewards. Ameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. Wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bihadi sayyid al-mursaleen. Aqulu ma tasma'un wa astaghfirullah al-Azim al-Jaleel li wa lakum. Wa li jami'i al-Muslimin min kulli dhanb. Fastaghfiruh innahu huwa al-Ghafoor al-Rahim. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, when we look at the situation of the early generations of the Muslims and how they received and welcomed the day of Arafah and what they used to do on the day of Arafah and how they would humbly submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Arafah, and they would let their emotions out on the day of Arafah begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their needs. There's a great example that we can strive to follow. Once during the time of the Tabi'een, one of the great scholars of the Tabi'een, Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, rahimahullah, he was at Arafah making Hajj, and the Muslims were there at Arafah, and they were all trying their best to make the most out of this opportunity, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, crying, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their needs, humbling themselves in pure submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, putting their hands out like beggars, because we are all beggars to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the way that we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Fudayl ibn Iyad, rahimullah, seeing all the Muslims begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a way, he asked a man who was with him, أَرَأَيْتُمْ لَوْ أَنَّ هَؤُلَاء صَارُوا إِلَىٰ رَجُلٍ فَسَأَلُوهُ دَانِقًا أَكَانَ يَرُدُّهُمْ. He asked his friend, see these people, how they're asking, how they're begging? If these people were to go to a man and beg him for a daniq. Daniq is a very small amount of money, 1/6 of a dirham, like a penny, for example. If they were to go and ask someone for one penny, begging like this, do you think anyone would turn them away, or they'll just give it to them? Would they be turned away? And then his friend said, La wallah, like no one would turn him away. If he's asking for something so easy like this and begging like this, of course nobody would turn him away. They'll give him what he's asking for. So then Fudail rahimahullah, he said, Wallahi, lal maghfiratu inda Allahi ahwanu min ijabati rajulin bidaniq. That for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant forgiveness to the people, that is simpler, that is easier, that is less of a deal than a man giving another man a small amount of money. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His treasures do not end. He has everything. وَلِلَّهِ خَزَائِنُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He can give you everything you ask for, and it will not take away anything from the treasures that He has. So beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will not be turned away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is أَكْرَمُ الْأَكْرَمِينَ. He is more generous than any creation. He's more generous than any man. So you ask Him, you beg Him, you humble yourself before Him, and surely He will answer you and He will give you. And then Fudail ibn Iyad rahimahullah, he mentioned some beautiful lines of poetry. He said, وَإِنِّي لَأَدْعُ اللَّهَ أَطْلُبُ عَفْوَهُ وَأَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْفُو وَيَغْفِرُ لَإِنْ أَعْظَمَ النَّاسُ الذُّنُوبَ فَإِنَّهَا وَإِنْ عَظُمَتْ فِي رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ تَصْغُرُ. He said, and surely I call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking for His pardon, and I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardons and forgives. Even if the people have great sins, those sins compared to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are small, because the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater than our sins. So keep this in mind, humble yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make use of the day of Arafah to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His pardon, for His forgiveness, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your needs, and you will not be turned away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to do what is pleasing to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our prayers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and pardon our shortcomings. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us upon the straight path. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with the good that we do during these blessed days. And may He forgive us for the mistakes that we make during these blessed days. هذا وصلوا وسلموا رحمكم الله على الرسول المجتبى والنبي المصطفى كما أمركم بذلك ربكم جل وعلا. فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد بن عبد الله وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم. ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا استووا، أقيموا صفوفكم، اعتدلوا ولا تختلفوا. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين لإيلاف قريش إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف الله أكبر سميع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده كثيرا طيبا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر Allahu Akbar. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakallahu khairan to Shaikh Ahson for leading us through this Jumua Khutbah. I have a few announcements to make. Regarding the first thing is this Sunday, inshallah, between Maghrib and Isha, we have a very renowned Qari Ibrahim Al Musalmi. He's going to be here at King Fahad Mosque for a program between Maghrib and Isha. So please join us. For the program. The second announcement I'd like to make is that inshallah on Tuesday we will be celebrating Eid al-Adha. The takbirat will begin at 7 a.m. sharp and the salah will begin at 7:30 a.m. So please make a note that the salah will begin sharp at 7:30 a.m. So please try and come in early, and also there's plenty of parking on the street. My third announcement is that, as you are aware, that every year King Fahad Mosque donates meat for Udhiyah to the needy and the poor people. So if you want us to take care of that for you, please contact Brother Nuri. Also, if you have any meat to donate on the day of Eid, you can, bring it to the masjid and there will be someone to take it, take care of it. For you, inshallah. So please make sure that you contact us accordingly. And finally, there will be a Salatul Janaza shortly right now after the announcements. So please just stay for a few moments to participate in it. And lastly, there will be no regular programs this weekend, starting from the Q&A or the tafsir or the regular classes that are held during the week, including the hadith class. There will be no classes this week. Inshallah, the following week will begin. Jazakumullahu khairan. We support your masjid.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulullah. A few dua requests. Sister Yusuf Hayat Ismail, she's ill. So it has been requested that we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives her a complete and speedy recovery. Allahumma rabban nas ati bil bas wa shfi anta shafi la shifa'a illa shifa'uk shifa'an la yughadiru saqama. Also, Brother Kenis Nazarov and Sister Faiqa Asindi and Brother Usama, they all passed away. So please make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives them and has mercy upon them. Also, Brother Sayyid Muhammad Idris, the father of one of our beloved community members who moved away from here a few years ago, Brother Razi, and his father, they were both actually members of this community. So Razi's father, Brother Sayyid Muhammad Idris, he passed away yesterday. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him and have mercy upon him as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of them. Allahumma ghafir lahum warhamhum wa'afihim wa'afu anhum wa'akrim nuzulahum wa'wasi' mudkhalahum واغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم جازهم بالحسنات إحسانا وبالسيئات عفوا وغفرانا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of them and have mercy upon them and give patience to their families. Also, there's a brother Abdul Rashid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon him, who passed away a little while ago, but his family was not Muslim. So when he passed away, sadly, no janazah was done for him and he was not buried in the Muslim way. So we're going to pray Salatul Janaza ala al-Ghaib for him, the absentee janaza prayer, because no janaza prayer was prayed for him. So please join me in that, inshallah. So for those of you who are unaware of how to pray the janazah prayer, it is 4 takbirat. After the first takbir, we recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Everything is done silently, of course. Recite Surah Al-Fatiha. After the second takbir, you pray for peace and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just like you do in the regular prayer. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Then after the third takbir, you make dua for the person who passed away. Allahumma ghfir lahu warhamhu. Even if you don't know, you know, a long dua, you can just say Allahumma ghfir lahu. May Allah forgive him. You can repeat that. Right? And then after the fourth takbir, there's a short pause, and then assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah on the right side only. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of you. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
One last announcement is that on the day of Yaumul Arafat, which is this Monday, there will be iftar distributed by King Fahad Mosque, in the evening, right before Maghrib. We will post the timing for the distribution a little bit ahead, but there will be iftar, so all of you are welcome to come in and break your fast with us. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum.